everybody, and welcome to Wednesday worship here at Paynesville Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Adam, and I am going to lead worship with you this evening. So glad for those of you who are tuning in live, welcome. And if you're watching later, thanks for taking time out of your day or night to spend a little time together and worship God and hear about God's love and grace for us tonight. Before we get going with worship, though, I wanted to start with a couple announcements as we begin our worship tonight. The first and kind of main announcement that we have tonight is that we are going to move ahead a little bit different with Wednesday nights going forward. We will not abandon worship on Wednesday nights. We will continue going, aside from when we move to something different in Lent. We will move ahead with worship continuing this way at 6 o'clock p.m. on Wednesday nights. And so if anything changes with that, we'll let you know. But as far as this is concerned, Wednesday worship continues ahead at 6 o'clock on Wednesday nights. And we'll continue it this way via YouTube Live. Until something changes, and we'll let you know if that does. The thing that we're going forward with differently on Wednesday nights is we are going to we're going to shift our energy a little bit on Wednesday nights. We have had a wonderful experience with those of you who have participated in the PLC Academy over the last several months leading into the new year. We had three-week sessions of the PLC Academy with all sorts of topics and things to learn about. We had so many people participate in it across a wide range of ages. We had a really good experience, and I know hearing from those of you who participated that it was an enriching experience. You learned a lot about things that you maybe hadn't spent a whole lot of time thinking about within your faith. And so we want to say thank you for those of you who have participated in the PLC Academy. We intended to keep going with the PLC Academy into the new year, beginning tonight. And so many of you who are signed up for the PLC Academy, this is going to be news to you. But we simply did not have enough people sign up to participate in the Academy this time around for us to put the amount of energy and time into building that program that we did over the last few months with the new topics coming up. We're grateful for those of you who did sign up, but we did not have enough people sign up for us to put our energy into that. So, hearing loud and clear that there was not enough interest in that particular way of doing things, we're going to focus our energy now into different ways of engaging the various groups that we were trying to reach with the Academy. So we are going to focus now our energy in kind of aged out, specific, intentional in-person or online, but kind of moving towards that in-person gatherings with smaller groups in safer numbers that we can try to meet the needs of our people in a better way. And so that might look like an event for our iQuest and Sunday school age kids, some learning events and some smaller gatherings with our confirmation groups and our high school groups. For those of you who continue to want to meet online and stay distant from folks, and maybe our older crowd that has been faithful in gathering with us, we might still offer some times to gather with the pastors or other leaders of this congregation in some Bible studies or some studies on specific topics. We're not going to abandon the things that we had put out for this particular session. We'll build those into our experiences, but we're going to shift our energy away from just the Academy and maybe building some more specific groups. We'll be in communication about that. You'll receive specific communication with your age group that you're in. as we develop those events and those experiences. But we are still going to offer the opportunity for our entire congregation, anyone who wants to gather at 6:30 on Wednesday nights for a Zoom check-in gathering. We want to continue offering the chance for us to get together and to check in with one another. We'll offer that online. We may also offer some chances to get together on Wednesdays in person. The first of these events that we are going to do, the first way that we are going to kind of shift our energy on Wednesday nights is to a bonfire worship next Wednesday. So what we'll do is we'll have Wednesday worship at 6 o'clock just like this. It'll be streaming live on YouTube, and but we will also invite you to come and be with us for a bonfire worship. We're going to have several bonfires set up in our parking lot. We're going to have some sort of similar setup as this for our worship time. And so you're invited to join us in person or online at 6 o'clock for worship. And then at 6:30, we'll have our Zoom check-in, but you can stick around and just hang out around the bonfire. We'll have several of them set up. We'll have s'mores. We'll have hot chocolate. We'll have bonfires going, and anybody and everybody is able to come and be a part of that. We do ask that you wear your masks while you're interacting with people or you're not enjoying refreshments, but otherwise, just come and be a part of checking in with each other and being a community in person. That's next Wednesday at 6 o'clock and at 6:30. But for those of you who want to stay home, we'll offer this online stuff as well. So you're not excluded as we shift away from that. For those of you who are excited about PLC Academy, thank you. And we will continue to engage you and that energy. But we are going to move away from that so that we can put our energy in the best places possible. So that's it for Wednesdays. Any questions, you can reach out to us and we'll be happy to answer them for you. We continue to worship online on Sunday mornings at 9:30 p.m. on our YouTube channel. We will, if and when we shift away from that as well, we will be in communication and get you all the information you need on that as well. That was a lot. Thank you for listening, and thank you for your participation on Wednesday nights. We're grateful for all of you who continue to show up and be a part of this community in this way. So let us now move into our time of worship, hearing those words that John declared in his gospel, that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. That great light is Christ, the Word made flesh and lives among us. And so as we light our candles, we invite you to light them at home as well. We ask God to kindle in us hope, to shine on us as darkness overwhelms, and to prepare our hearts to be transformed. O God, our light and our life, we thank you for coming to us this night. Amen. Well, our gospel text tonight comes from the Gospel of Luke, the 10th chapter, beginning with verse 25, and you will recognize it as the parable of the Good Samaritan. Just then a lawyer stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he said, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" He said to him, "What is written in the law? What do you read there?" He answered, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength, and your neighbor as yourself." And he said to him, "You have given the right answer. Do this and you will live." But wanting to justify himself, he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers who stripped him, beat him, and went away leaving him half dead. Now by chance a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise a Levite was coming to the place and came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him, and when he saw him, he was moved with pity. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil and wine on them. Then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, "Take care of him. And when I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend." Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers? He said, "The one who showed him mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." Well, I don't know if it is the being kind of in the dead center of winter that has me thinking of summer things, or just it popped into my head as I was thinking about tonight's worship. Our staff met this week also talking about Camp House. So Camp House has been kind of in my head lately, and it's kind of nice to think about being up on the North Shore in the summer right now, doesn't it? So hopefully that helps you kind of get through these cold days thinking about a good summer spot. But it made me think of Camp House and some of the work that we've done over the last several years at Camp House has been around peer ministry. And you could ask any number of our high school students that have gone through peer ministry in the last several years what a formative experience that has been, and how much they've taken from that, and how much they have continued to apply that in their life now. I still hear from some of our college students who are using the things and the skills and the gifts they learned through peer ministry in their own lives and in their lives of leadership now beyond high school and this particular place. But we start the peer ministry training at the beginning of the week. We start it with this Good Samaritan story. This is the foundation for all of the work that we do. Because it is important for us to center ourselves around the central question of peer ministry, which is, who is my neighbor? Who is my neighbor? And everything then flows from that question. How we treat our neighbor, how we show up for our neighbor, how we interact with people, and how we show God's love through our work of tending to our neighbor or our peer. How is it that we enter into the lives of another person, into the life of another person, and help them walk through this world that is so difficult and broken at sometimes? And so we start the week with the Good Samaritan story. And then that quickly shifts into one of the first kind of practices of peer ministry. And that is something that has been coined weeding. It's a verb you didn't know was a verb. You thought that wheat was just the thing that's in your pantry. How are you supposed to use that as a verb? Well, weeding, if I'll have Tammy put the card. Think of that what you see on your screen right now as a business card size. We hand these out at the beginning of our training and talk about what it is to wheat somebody. As you see on the screen right now, wheat is a form of interacting with someone, a way to kind of break the ice, a way to get to know your neighbor, which is kind of the first step of showing up and being in the life of someone else. And so this practice works with anyone. You could, Lyle Greiner, who is the director of peer ministry, He talks a lot about the stories where he's been able to wheat somebody. And one of the stories he uses is going up a chairlift on a ski trip where everybody was supposed to wheat the person that they were sitting next to in the chairlift. Talks about weeding people on an airplane, weeding people that he meets in a park. It could be anywhere, and it could be anyone, because the question, who is my neighbor, is, well, anyone. Anyone is your neighbor. Anyone is a perfect person to engage in conversation. You may not get a willing participant every time, but this practice of weeding, which is to at first ask someone, where are you from? Where are you going? Where have you come from? A good way to establish a conversation around where somebody might be from. The second is hobbies. That's a pretty easy one. It's a great way of getting to know somebody, is to ask what they're interested in doing. What are the things that give them life? What are the things they do when they have a little bit of free time? Experiences is the E of wheat. Experiences, things that this person has done, things that they have experienced in their life, whether it might be significant life moments like marriage or death or something that has happened to them, an experience that they've had. The A in wheat is acquaintances. You know, a lot of times we make connections with people based on something that they've told us and someone we know from that place that they're from, someone that's had an experience like them. We a lot of times don't have too many degrees of separation between others, and so maybe there's an acquaintance that we know that's gone to school at the same place they've gone or has worked the same place as they have worked. And the final one is travel. Where have they been? Where do they want to go? A great way to engage somebody in conversation is where they've been and where they want to go. I bring up weeding tonight because with the way that we are wanting to kind of shift our energy here at Paynesville Lutheran in the upcoming months, what's going to be key to that is connecting with people. Connecting with people in ways that goes a little bit deeper. That is focused on each person within our congregation, but also within our community and the larger world. How we are a community together and how we see each other as neighbors. And what that does for us in terms of following Christ and in following Christ's example. Because it is true that we should love our God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. And we should also love our neighbor as ourselves. And the way that we love our neighbor is by showing anyone, whoever it is, as it says, the one who showed him mercy. This is how we are neighbors to one another. By showing each other mercy. By taking the first step, which might simply be weeding somebody. Taking that first step to show them that someone is there for them. That someone cares about who they are and how they navigate this world. That experience of engaging in a little bit deeper than surface level conversation might show someone the mercy that they so desperately need. And so I want to encourage you. Maybe we'll do a little bit of encouragement, a little practice with our Zoom gathering after worship today. But I want to encourage you. I'm going to have Tammy quick put that wheat card back up on the screen. I want you to take a picture of it with your phone right now, or take a screenshot if you're watching worship on your phone. Take a picture of this or write down the wheat card. I want you to take this wheat card and I want you to practice on someone. I want you to Find someone this week to wheat, okay? I want you to ask them these questions and engage in conversation. And then I would like you to report back to me or report back to Pastor Paul. I want to hear about your weeding experiences, okay? So email us, text us, call us, whatever you need to do. I want to hear about your weeding experience as you engage in this practice, how you connected, and what happened. Maybe it was nothing. Maybe it was a really awkward interaction, or maybe it was something super profound, and you got a chance to be that mercy for somebody, as is talked about in the Good Samaritan story. To conclude, I want to focus on that mercy piece. We have the power and ability to be the merciful example of Christ's love in people's lives. You have been given that gift and that calling. And however it looks these days, no matter how connected or disconnected we feel, we have the power to be the people who show up and show mercy, who enter into each other's lives and give each other dignity and hope and joy, empathy, all of these things that define us as Christian people. We have been given that gift through Christ's love and mercy for us. And so it may start with this simple practice of weeding. But I hope that it encourages you to go deeper into what we've been called to as Christian people and as a Christian community. That we've been called to show mercy to our neighbor in whatever way that we can. And so let that also be your goal for this week and beyond. To find an opportunity to show someone mercy that they might not otherwise experience elsewhere. So that they might get a glimpse of Christ's love in their life in this moment. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we need look no further than your word in Scripture to find what it is we are called to do. We have first been loved by you, shown mercy through Christ. We have first been loved by you so that we can love you back and love our neighbor with the same kind of love. And so we ask that you send us out from wherever it is that we are, literally and figuratively, out of our houses or out of our jobs or out of our schools, but also out of whatever boxes we put around ourselves. Send us out to be the merciful example of your love to others, to our neighbors. Help us to shine your light into the world and give life to those who need it most. Bless our experiences and our interactions this week as we try to be that example and that mercy to others. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. We have for you tonight, Greater by Solid Rock. Enjoy.
With the voices that keep telling me I'm not right, that's alright, cause I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed, and I'll say I'll never be enough, and greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world, in the world. Fears, bring your hurt, bring your tears, there'll be no condemnation here. Oh, you're holy, righteous, and redeemed, and every time I fall, there'll be those that will call me a mistake. Well, that's okay, cause I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed, and I'll say I'll never be enough. And greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world, in the world, in the world. And greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world. And greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world, in the world, in the world. And greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world. Oh, 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 oh.
Always great to hear solid rock play, and we hope that you enjoyed that and got a little moment to worship in song tonight through them. So thank you to Solid Rock for playing that. Let us conclude our worship by using the words of confessing our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now we send you out with these words. People of God, we are sent to point others to Jesus. We are sent to love generously and gracefully. We are sent to cultivate disciples. Go in peace, sharing that peace with all God's people. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thanks for joining. Have a good night.